And so just to kind of have you guys brainstorm some of the things that we think are going to make us happy, some of the things that we think are going to make us have a successful life, what are some of the things that you think might matter? Like when you think about what are the kinds of things that you want to get out of this semester, what are some things that come to mind? Just kind of call them out. Yeah.
Good grades.
Good grades. Number one thing that comes out from Yale students who want this semester. How about after this? How about this summer? What are things that you want to get out of the summer?
Internships.
Internships. Any kind of internship? Do you want to be volunteered? Do you want to be
paid?
And what do you want if you could have low pay, high pay? What would you go for?
High pay.
So jobs, high pay. As you think about your life when you get out of here 5 years from now, what are some things that you'd like to see in it? You feel like this would make a successful life?
Grad school,
like getting into things that you want to get into, things that you plan on.
Good friendships and relationship with family.
Good friendships, relationships with family, having close connections with people. Other ideas? Although we'll get to that one because I bet a lot of you are applying for internships right now, but I bet very few of you are putting as much time as you're putting into your summer jobs into like making sure your friendships are going to be good next year. So hold that one for a second. So jobs, good salary, getting into grad school, good grades, other stuff. How about like, do you see yourself as like being in a relationship or married? People want that out of life? Think that's important? A lot of nods. Okay. So we got all these goals on the table. And what we're going to do is we're going to teach you guys that all those things, most of the things you said, aren't actually going to make you as happy as you think. So this is the warning, is that you're about to learn that everything you just thought was important for being happy is not. And I'll again pause in case anybody wants to like hold on to their false intuitions and leave here so you keep working on your grades. Everybody stay? Okay, good. Okay, so what are these kinds of goals that we think are going to make us happy that are false? Well, the first one is one that came up, which is that you think when you get out of here, you want a good job. In fact, some of the seniors who are finding this like a lot, when I talk to seniors here thinking, oh gosh, what's going to happen next year? I need to get a job and I need to get something that I care about. Like, is this really going to make us happy? And so there are all these jobs that I think Yaleys think are going to be really important, right? Maybe the like tech thing or maybe the, you know, the consulting-y things that make lots of money. A lot of you who are seniors are nodding because you're like getting emails about this stuff and thinking about this stuff. And you do this stuff because you think it's going to give you a good life and make you happy. Let's see if that's actually true. First off, let's see if actually getting a good job is going to make you happy. Some of you, when asked about the summer, said you wanted to get an internship this summer. How happy is it really going to make you to get the thing that you want as opposed to not getting it? Because sadly, some of you, for better or for worse, are going to apply for these things and it may or may not actually work out, right? So is this going to make you as unhappy as you think? Let's sort of simulate it. So pick the thing that you most want to do this summer. And let's say you apply. Let's say you don't get it. How's it going to make you feel? Well, in fact, Dan Gilbert and his colleagues actually did this. They actually set up college students with a potential job, a paid job that most college students found was really cool and they really wanted to get. And then they were to find out that they actually didn't get the job. And they were to predict how they were going to feel before and after this happened. And here's their little scale. This is the scale that they use. 1, you're going to be not very happy, and then 10, being very happy. So let's play along. First, your baseline. How happy are you right now on a scale of 1 to 10? You can just yell out some numbers. More numbers, come on.
6. 7, 6s,
okay. All right, so now you get the call. I'm sorry, you actually didn't get the job. Now how happy are you? What's your numbers?
4 is 5, 3.
All right, you guys really wanted this job. It's great. So this is what these students had to do. Predict, and then they actually find out. And how does it work, right? And so here's what Gilbert and colleagues actually found. So what if you found out that, you know, they looked at your qualifications and everything was fair and you just didn't get the job? Like, you just didn't have the qualification to get the job. What's your predicted drop in happiness? And so they're doing drops in happiness because, as you saw, people are starting with different numbers. Some was 8, some were 6, whatever. What we really want to see is what's the drop. And what they find is that in that scale, people are predicting that their drop in happiness is going to be about 2 points. What's their actual drop in happiness? Way less than a single point. Like, so it's a drop, but like it's not as much of a drop as you think. The more interesting thing comes when people thought that the decision wasn't fair, but was unfair. Like, imagine you could think, there was just something that happened in the interview, I said something dumb, they're not really looking at my qualification. Basically, all the kinds of rationalizations you would normally do if you didn't get a job. What if it was a case like that? How would you feel? Well, the prediction is that you're still going to drop in happiness just about as much. It's still going to be about a 2-point drop. But in practice, if you actually look, the actual drop is nothing. As soon as you can justify, like, they don't know what they're talking about, they're missing the best candidate they ever had in their life, whatever, as soon as you can do that, you get no drop in happiness. All your predictions about how you're going to feel when you don't get a job are just not true in practice, right? So that's getting any job. But as you guys talked about, what you want is a good job. You don't want the like internship where you don't make much money. You want the jobs with a lot of salary. And that's why so many students apply for these consulting, investment banking gigs. They make a ton of money. And you can see that not just from Yale students, but a recent survey by LinkedIn talked to recent grads and said, what do you want in a new job? And here are the data they put forward. And basically, most the highest thing up here is this thing right here, compensation. People want a big, high salary. They want to feel like they're getting paid a lot. And the question is, okay, that's great. You want a high salary, but what is a high salary? What counts as enough? And here's where we get to see that what we think counts as enough is kind of one of these visual illusions. It's another kind of misconception. So Sonia Lubomirsky, in her wonderful book, The How of Happiness, we'll see this book coming up a few more times, actually reported data about how much people really think is the salary they need. And they look depending on the salary you actually have. So imagine you're a person who gets out of here and you're earning about $30,000, and I ask you, what's the salary you think you need to be really happy, to have all your needs met, to feel like, you know, that's a job with like a good salary? And those folks at $30,000 will say in US dollars that what they really need is about $50,000. Great. So let's say we ask people who are earning $100,000 what they really want. Clearly, they're probably gonna be fine, right? They're probably like, I'd probably just use $50,000, but you know, it's kind of nice to get the extra cash. Right? They're going to be fine, right? But no, in fact, they too are like, nope, I'm not making enough. I should be making about $250,000. That is the salary I really need to feel comfortable, right? The point is that like, it's not just some objective number that we think. What we think we need actually jumps up every time we get more. And so this seems to be a problem for kind of finding a good job that's going to give us a good salary.